Hey everybody, Steve Mayne here. I believe we're live now. It looks like we are in fact up and running. Yes! So we are jumping into Stories, the Path of Destinies. There are... I've found six endings. All four truths. And I have a lot more to go through. So I've been... Well, here, let me go back here. So I've been trying to kind of figure out what I want to do next. And I think... Alright, so there are clearly three endings up here in the top. And I believe they all have to do with Lupino. I think that's why... If I can get this... That's why I think he's here. So I am going to just focus on Lupino stories tonight. And see if I can't muster out the rest of these endings.
The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky Ripper
had
surfaced.
Thanks for joining us.
Renata knew that using it could go catastrophically wrong. But he was sure he could figure out how to use it safely. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis stone was hidden there. It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it. To take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course. Renato had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion, and he had a gut feeling that he needed to use that to his advantage.
Of course, we also have the key thing up here, so... Well, like I said, I want to try and...
Renato finally realized that Lupino was a traitor to the cause, and maybe Renato could use that somehow.
Alright, well, let's see.
Renato couldn't quite put his paw on when he'd realized Lupino was working for the Empire. He'd never exactly seen Lupino sending coded messages to the palace, but he was sure. The rabbit had been on too many disastrous missions where he was the only survivor, or where he accidentally missed getting on the boat that went down to the abyss in flames. If Renato could prevent Lupino from getting back to the fleet with all the intelligence he'd probably gathered, it might be worth the trip.
So this is okay, so like the key is new, and maybe this unlocks something. I am curious to see what happens with the key. Because we've got that now. And it never said what it is, it just appeared. So it could be interesting to see what happens. I was in the middle of, thanks for joining us. If you have any questions, throw them up in chat. I promise to get to them as quickly as I notice them. I do get sometimes distracted by the game, but I try to look over as often as possible. Let me know if the sound is working as well. I do want to know that. Other than that, no, this game is fun. It's a narrative game. I'm loving this. Having a blast with the stories. Though some of them are a bit soul-crushy. Good lord. Soul Crushy is just only slightly descriptive. One or two of them have been.
How had they come to this? They'd been on so many adventures together. Lupino had talked Renato out of prison at least four times, and Renato had rescued Lupino from at least two lynch mobs.
Traitors!
Caught the ravens.
Oh.
Damn it!
Say hi to Gra-
But he'd always felt that the rabbit resented him. The peel was hilarious because he was so down on himself and everyone else. But behind the laughs, he wasn't a happy camper. Ooh, was this payback? Or did the Empire have his little white tail in a vice?
See, I could use the door. Ooh, I got a skill. Skill time! I've got two skills. Boy, I haven't been here in a while. Alright, let's see. Let's just ramp combo up. Let's see if there's...
Hero wall. Hero sword. Firewall. Fire. Extinguisher.
So I think I've been down this way before, I think. I mean, I have been here.
There was a cat in this one, and something useful.
Now that was Schrodinger's chest, clearly. Yes. Yes, I went there. I did. The game started it. They went there first. I followed them. I did it willingly, and I don't care who saw me do it. I'm gonna go down the... Oh, almost missed this. That would have been embarrassing. I'm gonna go down the well. Interesting. It just doesn't lead to anything over there. Huh.
He burned!
Ravens were landing everywhere from dropships. He'd better get moving. If they got to Lupino first, the rabbit would give the Empire all the intelligence he'd been stealing from the Rebellion, and they'd probably give him a medal. He'd have to be very careful about how he played Lupino. At the slightest hint of danger, the mad rabbit would take off like a... well, a rabbit.
Hey, giant. How you doing? Nah, don't worry, It was Mother's Day, man. Stuff happened.
Now, get your blood pumping like a bit of killing.
Oh, yeah. Well, I have not been able to get... I'm using 480p because I have not been able to get XSplit to broadcast it higher than that. I'm still fiddling around with it. I will probably have to figure it out at some point why it's doing that. But
bloody and exhausted, Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing shuffling his favorite deck. Now that he knew what the rabbit was, there are a few things about him that Renato didn't find so amusing anymore. You sent me an urgent message saying that you're in danger.
Oh, I am. The ravens are coming. Now, I've got a clever plan to kidnap Zenobia.
Renato wanted to clap shackles on the rabbit and shout, "You're a traitor, and I'm not falling for it." But if there was one thing Renato was sure of, it was that the core of the Sky River was dangerous mostly to its user. If he could put it in the Emperor's hands, old Isengrim III might blow himself and his fleet up with it. Yes, that was it.
I tried OBS at one point, and it just... fuzzes the background. Whenever anything moves, it fuzzes the background. If you go back and watch on my channel my first couple Life is Strange videos, whenever there's a lot of motion, everything gets fuzzy, and I didn't like that. XSplit records in 720. I have to, like I said, it's something I'm working at. One day I'm just going to sit down and do a whole bunch of streams, or just do test streams and try and fiddle around with it. It's just, I was running in the last few weeks of class for a semester, and I just haven't been able to get to it. Let's see. So this is a new one. That's old.
Bernardo felt like a real hero. Brave
true.
And smart. He told the rabbit all about the Sky Ripper's God's Eye Core.
Oh,
I'll go get the core while you attack Zenobia, he told the rabbit. But wait, I have a better idea. I'll get the core and you attack Zenobia, said the rabbit. Right, yeah, that is better, agreed Renardo. Perfect. The traitor would make sure the Emperor got the core. Now Renardo just needed the Emperor to use the core. If he could only get something that the Emperor wanted very badly. Zenobia. He could save her and bait the Emperor at the same time.
Sorry, it's a custom rig. I use a custom computer. Fred helped me build it. I don't know the stats off the top of my head. I'm sorry. It's really good. It was a gaming rig suggested
now,
by a website.
All Renato had to do was fight his way through Zenobia's invading troops, sneak onto her ship and into her bedroom, and kidnap her without any of her dozens of guards alerting her. Then he would rely on her love for him to convince her how evil her father was, so she'd run away with him instead of going back to her father, who was going to blow himself up. It did sound a little risky. But Renato had a feeling it would work out somehow. It always did.
Oh, hey, no worries. I'll handle questions. I'm good. I'll just stop talking when the story happens. Have you tried this game out? Giant? I love the Arkham combat. I mean, it's Arkham Light, but it feels, especially once you start ramping up and getting new skills and bonuses and stuff, it starts feeling really solid. And come on, brother, let's do this. What do we got? What do we got? What do we got?
So that's what they meant by a firewall. What unlocks a firewall?
Oh. God, the puns.
This chest smelled kind of funky. He hoped he didn't get it in his clothes.
A lot of dead people here. Wanna go through the sewers or... I think I've found everything I can from a chest at this point. Yeah, I'm just getting health now. Which is pointed.
The market. It was going to be full of gogglers, wasn't it? Oh, it'd have been so much more fun before the war. When the worst thing that could happen to you was getting fleeced buying a rug.
Oh, good lord. Thing hit hard. I was almost at full health a minute ago. Did not expect that.
Renato hated gogglers. I freaked him out.
I thought I got them both. Oh, bugger. Okay. Important safety tip. Okay, they have upgraded those things significantly. And with Wild Abandoned, I will add.
Renato was halfway to Zenobia's encampment when Lupino showed up. He was disheveled and distraught.
They jumped us. I barely got away. Oh, they got the core.
Oh, it was all going according to plan, thought Renato. Now he just needed Zenobia on his side. Yes, that was even better. The Iblis Stone. Zenobia could get it. And then the Emperor would have to pursue them. Wait. No. The gem would corrupt anyone, even her. That's it, he thought. Even Lupino. Even though Lupino was already a traitor, it would turn him against his secret master, the Emperor. He would try to make himself Emperor. And the Emperor would have to defend himself with the core. Boom. He was a super genius.
Let's send Lupino.
This is terrible, Renato told the rabbit. If only I had gone for the Iblis Stone. But now it's lost in enemy territory. He handed Lupino a map. It gives the bearer so much power. We can only hope the Emperor never finds it.
What was that? Said Lupino. I think someone's following us.
I didn't hear anything.
Rabbit ears. You go on ahead. I'll check it out.
And with that, Lupino hopped off with the map.
Very nice. Run, you stupid rabbit. There's a chest through here. I can use it to get health.
Ah, the road less traveled, Fortunato. How intriguing.
This is... Yeah, this is the one where he's gonna send her to her doom. Explains the whole sacrificing his daughter thing. Why it's such a sad event, but it's not his fault. Yeah. Yes, yes. Oh. Nice. The boat.
Renato slinked through Zenobia's ship, making no sound at all. She was curled up on her bed. He'd forgotten how beautiful she was. How sleek. How soft. He tapped her on the shoulder with his sword. She was made of smoke, and he noticed he had a very solid blade to his throat. Did you really think you could capture me? Heard a familiar voice. I just wanted to chat, said Renato. Did you ever wonder why the Emperor adopted you? He needs a sacrifice. Someone who truly loves him, to make a bargain with the lost gods. That's a vicious lie. He wants to bring them back. That's crazy. Why would anyone... They could make him immortal. An eater of souls. And with that, her eyes widened. She understood. Renato told her how he had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred. How he had slept in a burnt village. At midnight, the Emperor's victims had come to him in his dreams to tell him of the hideous eldritch rituals they'd been sacrificed in. He could still see those kittens and puppies. Their wide, sad eyes, their moist noses. You can't prove that. I've got a witness at the observatory.
If the Emperor gets both the core and the Idlis stone and puts them together, he'll find inner peace.
Not yet. Why he was really here. He didn't want her to be anywhere near the fleet when her father blew himself and Lupino up. So he told her about how the Emperor's obscene rituals had raised ancient artifacts out of the land. How he'd followed the appalling trail of the hideous horrors his Majesty had perpetrated for the sake of his own immortality. Any of this ring a bell? He said. He told me it was all lies. You've always known when I was lying. I always hated that about you, said Renato. The rebellion had started after atrocities that the Empire hushed up. Renato had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred for one book. He had slept in a burnt village. Dead kittens and puppies had come to tell him what the Emperor had done to them. This would be the perfect place for a tic-tac-toe board.
Okay, non-sequitur from hell right there. Head back. Up the stairs, up the stairs. That's pretty good. Let's just run. A weird pause, but hey, we win, so who cares?
Yeah!
Don't you think I'd know if my father started practicing black magic? Why? Would you join in? No! I'd destroy his books and I'd... Oh, God. Okay, you're not completely wrong. They've resurrected one of his victims. Well, look, I mean, look, it's not exactly alive, but it can talk. A true witness, she said.
So weird, the last time we did this, Lupino screwed it up and had everybody killed. Since he's running after the Iblis stone, is he even going to be able to stop the confession this time? I don't... It's going to be interesting to see how this goes. I don't know what's going to happen next.
Energy balls, immune to the laws of gravity.
Do this. Down with you, brother. Still, I marvel at the backgrounds on this game. They are fantastic and beautiful on every level. Everything about these is amazing. It's still gone.
The observatory was a burning hulk. Dead scientists and black feathers everywhere. The Ravens had taken special care to burn the reanimated witness to cinders. Zenobia stared at the carnage. He didn't want me to hear the witness, did he? I guess not. What's your plan? She asked. So, Renato explained his brilliant gambit. Sending Lupino to get the Iblis Stone, become super powerful and corrupted, provoke the Emperor into using the core against him, thus blowing up both of them, and hopefully the fleet too. Let me visit your council, she said, shaken. I want to help. Could he really trust her?
Let's do the right thing here. Let's take the shot.
He made Zenobia see how evil her father really was. He wished she didn't feel this urge to join in the rebellion. After all, he'd taken care of the Emperor, right? Yeah, but she'd always been conscientious like that. She told him she had to go somewhere first. So Renato gave her the location of the secret base, and they agreed to meet in the ruins. He had a very good feeling about this.
Oh, I have a very bad feeling about this. This won't be going well for us today, I don't think. I do not believe this is going to end at all, as we had hoped.
What had Zenobia gone off to do? What was more important than meeting the Rebel Council? Had he made a mistake? Sending her to the ruins? No. He knew they could trust each other. He could trust her because she never broke her word. and she could trust him because she could see right through him. Well, she'd probably be there well before him. She at least didn't have to fight her way through rainstorms of ravens.
Nicely done, Renata.
Hypatia. Oh, she'd been an amazing rabbit. She could talk to him about comics, and talk to her son about history and battles, and talk to scholars about the ancient tomes hidden deep in the vaults of the Library of Ubar. Oh, Renata really missed her.
Uh-oh. Do this. Well, let's take this one. This seems like a direction in which I can.
There was an inscription on the platform. Balalaika lessons with an address.
I know it's this way. You don't think I've ever come this way before. I'm hard pressed to remember having done it. I don't wish to use that. That's what you use in case you can't open the door. I can open the door, so we'll go this way. Mathematically, thousands and thousands of platforms. It's platformapalooza, and this is going to be a trap. Let's put on the ice sword.
This could be the new aerobics craze. Am I right?
Sure, why not? Clearly, this is not the direction I go. Very slowly and steadily finding everything down here.
As he came around the bend, there was Lupino, unconscious on the side of the path, and Renata could smell a familiar, sweet, smoky scent. Who? Zenobia. It had to be. She never used a combat spell when she could use drowsy gas. That meant she had the Iblis Stone. What would it do to her? She hated her father now. She'd kill him for sure. The Council wouldn't mind if she killed the Emperor, but murdering her father would destroy her. He had to get to whatever ledge she was on and talk her down from it.
Especially since if she has the stone, she's gone full evil now. Where's the elder? kill all those things, just enough of them.
The long stairs. So he was close to the rebel base. Nothing was on fire. So far, so good.
Through here and see if I can't get lucky and get some energy. A full health. Nope. Alright, I go in with what I have. And hope for the best. Let's hope this doesn't go badly. Although I can't imagine
in the council chamber was dead. Zenobia stood shivering in the courtyard, drenched in blood. Why? He managed.
They started arguing with me. I lost my temper and I wanted their blood. Well, not me. The stone did. Why did you take it from Lupino? I had a plan. You had a stupid plan, she said. I'm going to go kill my father now. No, you can't. You'll just take his place. You'll become worse than him. Get out of my way, or I'll kill you too.
So you try to stop her would likely be fatal. So let her go, see what happens. Trying to stop her would be likely fatal, but the feeling she had for him, right? Had to mean something, right? Oh, wow. Do I stop her? I have to stop her.
Renata watched her board her ship and sail off. A few days later, the sun dimmed. A great void opened in the sky, black as the Ibla stone itself. It stretched and ripped like a vast fatal womb, and a gaze black and pitiless as the sun passed through the void into the land, and so the lost god Iblis once again came into his own, and time stopped. He had tried something bold and paid the price for it.
Yep. I didn't even have to assault the Emperor's fleet that time. Wow. That was a record. I'd actually meant to choose the other one. I screwed
that up. What had Zenobia gone off to do? What was more important than meeting the Rebel Council? Had he made a mistake, sending her to the ruins? No. He knew they could trust her. He could trust her because she never broke her word. And she could trust him because she could see right through him. Well, she'd probably be there well before him. She at least didn't have to fight her way through rainstorms of ravens.
Alright, well, that was interesting.
I wondered how much Hypatia had known about the book she protected. Enough to tell her son to protect it. Enough to tell Renato to protect her son. He let her down there.
We can do this. We are mighty sword-wielding lunatics. Yeah, I notice it doesn't even have the upgrade information in the upper right-hand corner anymore. Now let's get this and get some health.
As he came around the bend, there was Lupino, unconscious on the side of the path. And Renato could smell a familiar, sweet, smoky scent. Who? Zenobia. It had to be. She never used a combat spell when she could use drowsy gas.
Well, that meant sucked.
She had the Imbliss Stone. What would it do to her? She hated her father now. She'd kill him for sure. The Council wouldn't mind if she killed the Emperor, but murdering her father would destroy her. He had to get to whatever ledge she was on and talk her down from it. Hey, why don't you guys fight in groups? Oh, I know. Because there's no I in team.
Ooh.
The long stairs. So he was close to the rebel base. Nothing was on fire. So far, so good.
Time we'll take the choice I'd meant to the first time. Although it's interesting, it's not making me go all the way back to the beginning now, it's just making me go back to the last choice.
Everyone in the council chamber was dead. Zenobia stood shivering in the courtyard, drenched in blood. Why? He managed. They started arguing with me. I lost my temper and I wanted their blood. Well, not me. The stone did. Why did you take it from Lupino? I had a plan. You had a stupid plan, she said. I'm going to go kill my father now. No, you can't. You'll just take his place. You'll become worse than him. Get out of my way, or I'll kill you too.
This time, let's...
You won't kill me, he said. And I won't let you kill the Emperor. Enraged, she raised the sword. You hate him too? He could sense the Imbliss Stone, yearning for his death. But she didn't strike. If you kill him, he'll destroy you. I know you. Shut up! She shouted, her sword trembling. I won't lose you again. Not for anything. Get away from me!
God, let this
she
one
said,
work.
And he was very close. I can't lose you again. And he was in reach of her sword now. I hate him! I hate you too! I love you, he said for the very first time. And then she was weeping. He was holding her. The sword had dropped from her hand. He glanced at the Imbliss Stone. It was no longer the black of the void. It looked like coal. No. It glowed. Like a cinder. It was crackling, burning, crumbling into ashes. You've always loved me, haven't you? She said. She was weak. The stone had taken so much from her. Always, he said. She staggered as he helped her up. Let me take you away. Where? The island of Avalon. The sisters will heal you. He'll follow us. Then we need the Farfarer, the fastest ship in the Empire.
Oh man, this is... I don't want this one to end badly. I want this one to succeed. To make it to... go forward. I just don't think it's gonna. Crap.
The Empire had seized his ship. They'd have to take it back.
And I'm low on health. Who's beyond all recognition? Well, this does help me shortcut the great deal of the fleet.
Renato had a feeling that was the back door to something. But what?
I've done this before. I don't remember looking like this. Health will be useful. There'll be another one in a second. Here she comes.
There it was, his beautiful skycraft, the Farfarer. They would fare very far indeed, beyond the Empire, beyond the reach of the Empire, to the mystical island of Avalon. He didn't know exactly where it was, but he knew he could find it. And they would find peace there, second star on the right, and straight on till morning, laughed Zenobia. And they laughed together for the first time in a long time.
Let's grab this, because it isn't going to be easy getting that ship.
Hey, what do ravens say when they die? Never mind, I'll wait.
So close. Am I gonna get a good ending this time?
Don't look down, he told himself. Don't look down.
So many of these puzzles. That's not the way I'm going this time. I'm going for my ship. What will happen when I find it? Anybody's guess.
Thank you.
Holy crap! How many of these people are there? Yeah, I was about to complain that the game had gotten too easy, but apparently we've decided to just ramp up the difficulty level by throwing another 30 guys at me.
But they did not go unnoticed. Scout ships lifted off, and the long lance of the Imperial flagship. Bernardo turned downwind to gain speed. The Raven ships could pursue, but they couldn't close. The Farspeaker croaked, "Return her and live! Go sacrifice yourself," yelled Renardo.
"Then you won't have her either."
On the flagship, the Emperor was readying some arcane weapon. It couldn't be. It was the core. A devastating beam lanced out of the flagship. Renardo zigzagged wildly to keep the Farfare out of it. Now the Raven scout ships were closing the distance, and the beam was getting closer too. Then came a blinding flash, and the air was searingly hot all around him. There was a thunderous, deafening roar. He could smell burnt oak and burnt feathers and burnt flesh. But when he could hear and see again, they were alive and unhurt, and they were alone in the sky. Zenobia embraced him. They had done it. Through luck and through love, they had won the war. "Avalon, here we come," he said as he held her arms wide in the prow of the boat and let her feel its speed. "Maybe the real Avalon is wherever we're together," she said. And so, after a bit of an argument, Renardo and Zenobia went to one of the two Avalons. The one shrouded in mists, or the one in their hearts. But which one they went to, I'll never tell. He'd done it. He'd forged his own destiny. Well, he hadn't actually done it. But he knew what he would do. Renardo smiled at the book. He practically wanted to kiss it. The kid's sacrifice hadn't been in vain. He'd saved the book and saved the world. Renardo owed him and his mother so much. Renardo lowered the mainsail and let the Farfarer shoot forward in the breeze. Second star to the right and straight on till morning. This time, he would win.
Oh. Wow. Oh, man. Well, that's the one true ending. Oh, man. This was such a good game. The mechanics for this are amazing. I'm curious what the other endings are, but I mean, I almost don't want to do them for fear of kind of ruining. Not ruining. I don't know. I mean, okay. I don't think it'll take away from anything, but. Oh man, so good. I mean, I would like to see the other endings just to know what they all are. So far, everything in this has been so beautiful. These stories have been so nice. I mean, yeah, there's only so many levels, and that's going to be the problem, but. But I don't know, like, it doesn't bother me that I'm repeating the same levels. Because I get different dialogue as I run through them and hear different stories. I get to see the characters learn and grow and get better at what they do. And just, I don't know, like, it's one of those things where, like, this was such a beautiful experience. And, I mean, it took me 8 endings to get to the quote-unquote real one. Which I like, because I don't. Because it's impossible, I think, to get through it on the first time and get the real ending. Which I think would be a cheat, but, like, because you can't get the real ending if you don't know Lupino's a spy. And you can't find out Lupino's a spy until you've played through the game at least once. And you can't find out... I mean, like, you need to get all four of the truths to be able to get the quote, true ending. I think it's interesting, though, that I mean, I wasn't trying to. I want to see the endings, and I will probably continue to play this just too. But I think it's interesting that I kind of managed to do it in the quickest way possible, I think. Even unwittingly, just to break through and get the other endings. Let's see, the Truth Finder will help you find the paths that lead to the truths you have not found yet. Look for this icon when making choices in the book. Well, let's find out what that means.
The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky Ripper had surfaced. Renata knew that using it could go catastrophically wrong, but he was sure he could figure out how to use it safely. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis Stone was hidden there. It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it, to take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course, Renato had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion, and he had a gut feeling that he needed to use that to his advantage.
All right, so I don't. Well, let's see. I wonder if it's even possible now to get the endings I haven't gotten. Because, like, if you look at them, like, some of these involve, I think, going along with Lupino in a way that I haven't yet. Alright, let's try Lupino's story one last time.
Renato finally realized that Lupino was a traitor to the cause, and maybe Renato could use that somehow.
Alright, so I did this alright, but let's go do this one.
Ah, Lupino. Apparently, the mad rabbit had sold a Pegasus that he did not exactly own. Lupino always wiggled out of trouble, given time. But he was out of time. Lupino's frantic message said that the Ravens were going to kill him for being a rebel spy. And that he had a clever plan. If the fleet reached him first, they'd string him up for that. Never mind the winged horse. Or so Lupino had told him over the far speaker anyway.
Alright, well, let's try this. See if we can't find a couple of solutions that we haven't yet.
Lupino had apparently managed to confuse the judge by arguing that he hadn't actually stolen the winged horse. He'd only sold it. But wait, where was the prison? The village was empty. Had everybody fled the Ravens?
What is that thing that's following me?
That was awesome!
I now have a weapon following me. I did not anticipate. I don't.
That was odd. Renato had been here, at this exact place, at this exact time. But this time, there were so many more Ravens.
It's a giant death orb. Let's not forget the giant death orb. And the giant death orb is somewhat concerning since it's new. I mean, I'm not, like, complaining, it's just surprised.
This is the craziest weapon you've ever used.
Or not. Ravens were landing everywhere. The advance guard. He'd better get moving. If they got to Lupino first, they'd eat him for breakfast. Or a snack. Ravens weren't picky. If they got hungry, they sometimes forgot to interrogate their prisoners. Even top spies like Lupino. Well, unless he really was a traitor, obviously. Then they'd probably pin a medal on his chest. Dirty and bloody, Renardo finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing his shuffle. Bernardo recognized the cards. It was Lupino's favorite deck. Oh, I thought you were in danger.
I am. The ravens are coming. Oh, the prison thing. Right, yeah, we see this guard owed me 53 ducats, so we made a deal. They're very reasonable people, actually, for weasels. Now, I got a brilliant plan to kidnap Zenobia. We capture Zenobia, we find out what she knows, and that's the whole war right there. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
Capture the Emperor's greatest general, who happened to also be a deadly sorcerer, and, oh, his only daughter? Ah, that would be worth it. And it would be nice to see her. He'd always had a soft spot for her. And he felt sure she had one for him. On the other hand, he could still get to the core of the Sky Ripper. Even if he couldn't get the whole thing, it must have great power. To make the Sky Ripper, the Transcendent Emperor had wrapped an armature around the eye of a god. Renardo had already let that armature slip away to save Lupino's life. But even its core, the eye torn from a god, surely they could fashion a great weapon from that.
The core of the Sky Ripper? Lupino's excited. That's an actual thing that we could just go and get. You've been busy.
He sure had. Renardo told him all the things he'd been up to. Soon they got to talking about old times, about wages they'd won and lost, and scrapes they'd barely got out of. It was good to be back with his friend. Aww. True, the core was capable of terrible, uncontrollable destruction. But this time, he was sure it would work great.
You fool! Stupid, superficial idiots. Never goes well. Let's see what's next.
It's beautiful here, thought Renardo. It was nice to be back with his old war buddy. All right. Lupino was a traitor. But still, it was good company.
Down the hole. I think I've only done this one. No, I've done it twice. Once with the Obelisk Stone and once without. Well, you know, once without and then once with.
There was something sour in the air. Like the earth had ruptured over something that had been fermenting for a very long time.
It's nice having your own miniature Renardo Death Star.
Wrong. All over. He could feel an almost palpable sickness in the air. And if the land could have tumors, they would look like these monstrous crystals. The forest was quieter than it had been. There were insects, but few birds, if you didn't catch the ravens. Renata smelt sick animals and dying ones, but no healthy ones. And getting a bad feeling about this, Renata thought. Maybe Lapina was right. Maybe they should have kidnapped Zenobia instead of coming here.
Now let's run faster.
Boy, with this device you could travel at night, so long as there are ravens to set on fire.
Well, we are certainly just making the continued playthrough of this for the extra endings easy as hell. Ooh, and it's taking damage. That is something to remember.
As he held the radiant icosahedron, Renato felt queasy. Like dozens of tiny worms were nibbling his insides. It wasn't healthy to be so close to the eye of a god. How could he use it? He could take it to the observatory. The scientists there could tell him how to harness its ancient power. But honestly, Renato ached to get away from it. He brought the core back with him to the Farfarer. But honestly, Renato ached to be rid of it.
Tell you what, said Lupino. I'll take it to the observatory. You attack the Imperial outpost.
The Imperial outpost was a vital communications node. Taking it could shatter the Empire's ability to coordinate. And it would be full of secret plans and maps and maybe even rebel prisoners. It was a good target for a hero like Renato. But what if Lupino lost the core to the Empire? That could be a good thing. Couldn't it? Was Renato ready to take that risk? Maybe it was better if he brought the core to the scientists himself.
I've been this way. You know, I've been to the center. I'm going to do this one because I don't think
Trust
I have
Renato,
been this level.
You won't regret this. I'll treat the core like it was my own baby daughter.
As the Farfarer dived towards the Nexus, Lupino was jumping up and down with excitement. Stop rabbiting around, Renato said. Lupino just stared at him. The moment the ship landed, Lupino leapt off the ship.
Yeah.
As Lupino vanished into the wilds of the Nexus, Renato vaguely remembered Lupino had a baby daughter, didn't he? And he told her mother he was going out to get some Easter eggs, and he'd never come back. But Renato was relieved not to carry the core anymore. He was already feeling better. And who knows, maybe this time Lupino would get it right. And if Renato could take the outpost, he'd have access to all the Empire's communications in the sector, right? A very clever engineer named Elon Muskrat had got his start making floating platforms. Not many people knew that.
God, the puns. Little Death Star toy. Death Star, don't leave home without one. care about that. Can't go that way.
Renato caught his breath. His joints still hurt, but he couldn't feel the poison in his system anymore. He'd let the armature slip out of his hands to save his friend Lupino. Of course he had to let Lupino take the core. The rebellion needed every man doing his duty. And the rabbit would be no good taking on an Imperial outpost, right?
Yeah, basically. Me and my new best friend.
Renato took the outpost with a
shooty McBlasty orb.
Soon he was stuffing his sack with key messages from and to the fleet. Then the fire speaker toad chortled a new message. The observatory had been sacked by ravens. Lupino and all the scientists had been taken to the mountains. Why? Why had he trusted Lupino again? And now the Empire had the core. Renato hailed the rebel base to warn them. But their fire speaker didn't crowd back. Was the base under attack too? Lupino would have to wait. The core would have to wait. Renato had a very bad feeling that something was going terribly wrong at the rebel base.
Of course.
Its location was secret, but secrets can be discovered.
Well, secrets actually always come out. It's the nature of a secret is that it wants to be known. I think it was Terry Pratchett who said something like secrets are living things that desire to find
the
light.
There were Imperials everywhere in the ruins, and dead civilians. The ravens were killing everything in sight. Renato was relieved to see no rebels among the dead. Maybe the secret base was still secret. But there were huge burn marks on buildings. What monstrous weapon was the Empire using here? The core had great power. And they harnessed it somehow, even though they didn't have the armature. Funny about librarians. People thought of them as fussy clerks who shushed them for talking. But the librarians thought of their books as sacred, and themselves as priests in a temple of knowledge. Who knew they were willing to die to protect it? Renato thought about the intel he'd gathered from the outpost. Who would he bring it to? Who even had time to read it? He could smell charred flesh and hear screams. The ruins were on fire. But the ravens had rigged up the core as some kind of burning ray. They wouldn't need to know the secret location. They were burning everything. It was killing them too. Their black feathers littered the path. He would have to take the core from them. It was the last thing he wanted to do. These things really slice like ham.
I don't think I ever needed to know that.
The rebel base seemed quiet. That was good. Also, it seemed to be burning. That wasn't so good.
Let us in! Let us in!
Thank you.
As the last raven fell, Renato felt worse than he ever had. The core was killing him again. The council members cautiously came out into the smoke.
You saved us,
croaked the speaker. They would put the weaponized core deep in a cavern, she promised, where its poison could harm no one. They would heal him if they could, she said. No, it's a weapon now. We need one. I'll lead the charge.
It will kill you,
croaked the speaker. I guess it already has, Renato said. She bobbed her head gravely.
When all this is over,
she said,
we'll name our new capital city for you.
He flew towards the Imperial fleet.
Coming from the town of Renato.
Waiting for the signal to destroy the rebellion forever. Behind him, the rebels were charging. If he failed, they would die. And so the final battle began.
I come from the city of Renato, capital of the Empire. Yeah, I could see that. I'll run with it. That's a good name.
Everything hurt. It was unpleasant to fight this way. With each blow he struck with his sword, he felt weaker. Yet each time the core fired, it got brighter. As if the heat from the burning ravens and buildings only fed its hunger. He wondered where Lupino was. Wasn't he supposed to be in the battle? No. He'd been captured, hadn't he? Oh, Renato's mind was smoky now, like the burning fleet. He hoped this wouldn't take long. Sometimes, all you know is what you know. You know?
There's more around here that I'm just not seeing for some reason. I could use the health.
Renardopolis. Vulpus Major? Lando Nardo. If they were going to name a capital city after him, well, he just wished he had a better name. Where is Lupino? He missed Lupino's bitter outburst. Or did he? Lupino had gotten him into this mess, hadn't he? The core was a wonderful weapon. It swept fire across the fleet. Ravens exploded in its gaze, and with every heartbeat, it grew brighter. He would die. But he would die every inch a hero. Spectacularly, changing history like the legendary heroes of lore. Or his cure.
There was an engraving. Maximum capacity, 130 people.
That seems excessive. My new toy coming along behind me. We're gonna go up there, we're gonna kill some ravens. And have ourselves a nice time doing it.
Renardo fell to his knees. The Emperor's bodyguards were lined up before his ship. Fierce ravens, all. And Zenobia. She was conjuring. He could not take another step. All he could do was fire the core. The ravens, Zenobia, the ship, all burst into flames, disintegrated, and blew away. So they had won, after all. The core grew brighter. He shielded his eyes, but he could still see it through his sleeves and through the flesh of his arm. And then he felt heat, as the fire grew to consume both fleets. And then he felt nothing.
I found that one. Oh, alright. I hear who goes out in a blaze of glory. Renardoopolis. I think we have time for one more. Maybe.
The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky Ripper had surfaced. Renardo knew that using it could go catastrophically wrong. But he was sure he could figure out how to use it safely. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis Stone was hidden there. It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it. To take its power without surrendering to its wickedness. Yeah. And also, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course, Renardo had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion. And he had a gut feeling that he needed to use that to his advantage. Renardo finally realized that Lupino was a traitor to the cause.
Let's try this one again. There were a couple decisions.
Maybe Renardo could use that somehow.
Of course, there were a couple decisions that way I didn't use either, but let's try this.
Ah, Lupino. Apparently, the mad rabbit had sold a Pegasus that he did not exactly own. Lupino always wiggled out of trouble, given time. But he was out of time. Lupino's frantic message said that the ravens were going to kill him for being a rebel spy, and that he had a clever plan. If the fleet reached him first, they'd string him up for that, never mind the winged horse. Or so Lupino had told him over the far speaker anyway.
All right, so this time I'm going to go through, and I mean, admittedly, I'm going to hit a lot of the same stuff. It's the last decision I'm going to make differently, the one where,
Lupino had apparently managed to confuse the judge by arguing that he hadn't actually stolen a winged horse. He'd only sold it. But, wait. Where was the prison? The village was empty. Had everybody fled the ravens?
Ferocity. If the palace was a woman, he'd buy the drink.
That was odd. Renardo had been here, at this exact place, at this exact time. This time, there were so many more ravens.
So basically this time, instead of going to the rebel base, I'm going to go save Lupino and the scientists. Which will get me a different thing.
Yeah.
ravens were landing everywhere. The advance guard. He'd better get moving. If they got to Lupino first, they'd eat him for breakfast. Or a snack. Ravens weren't picky. If they got hungry, they sometimes forgot to interrogate their prisoners. Even top spies like Lupino. Well, unless he really was a traitor, obviously. Then they'd probably pin a medal on his chest.
Lupino!
Dirty and bloody, Renardo finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing his shuffle. Renardo recognized the cards. It was Lupino's favorite deck. Oh, I thought you were in danger. I am.
Seed.
The ravens are coming. Oh, the prison thing. Right, yeah, we see this guard owed me 53 ducats, so we made a deal. They're very reasonable people, actually, for weasels. Now, I got a brilliant plan to kidnap Zenobia.
We capture Zenobia, we find out what she knows, and that's the whole war right there. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
Capture the Emperor's greatest general, who happened to also be a deadly sorcerer, and, oh, his only daughter? Ah, that would be worth it. And it would be nice to see her. He'd always had a soft spot for her. And he felt sure she had one for him. On the other hand, he could still get to the core of the Sky Ripper, even if he couldn't get the whole thing. It must have great power.
Alright, so we're gonna go to the Sky Ripper again.
The Transcendent Emperor had wrapped an armature around the eye of a god. Renardo had already let that armature slip away to save Lupino's life. But even its core, the eye torn from a god, surely they could fashion a great weapon from that.
The core of the Sky Ripper? Lupino's excited. That's an actual thing that we could just go and get. You've been busy.
He sure had. Renardo told him all the things he'd been up to. Soon they got to talking about old times, about wages they'd won and lost, and scrapes they'd barely got out of. It was good to be back with his friend. True, the core was capable of terrible, uncontrollable destruction. But this time, he was sure it would work great.
All right, so far, I think we're doing okay. I love this game.
It's beautiful here, thought Renardo. It was nice to be back with his old war buddy. All right, Lupino was a traitor. But still, it was good company. Ah, Zenobia. Now that he knew she still loved him, he wanted to go back to her. But that hadn't worked out, had it? Maybe it was time to find the core of the Sky Ripper.
Huh. Got the ice sword all geared up here. Might as well use this one. I tell you another thing I'm really enjoying. Oh, have I read this one? The director of the academy has told me how much he is impressed by your academic performance and leadership. Somehow, I doubt this was a session of bootlicking. I have seen plenty of those. That old toad is sincere. I am proud of you, my daughter. You will make a fine empress one day. On my end, great news. Professor Calvaris has been studying Nexus and has made a bold observation. That toad is a true genius. You know how that island is unique, constantly changing new crystalline formations, appearing island fragments, merging, splitting, slowly drifting, held together by some invisible thread. Calaveras is convinced this change is not random, but rather indicative of the living nature of the islands. He has observed that certain changes on the Nexus follow, or sometimes precede, a turbulence on another island. Landslide, quake, flood, the Nexus seems to be resonating with those events. Maybe the islands are a hive mind, and the Nexus is the brain. In any case, I am funding a permanent scientific observatory on the Nexus. It will attract the Emperor's greatest minds, with Professor Calaveras at the helm. I anticipate that a great age of enlightenment for the Empire with love, Father. Like, one thing I love is the world they've built. I almost wish they would do like an RPG in this setting, because like they talk about how if you go down, because you know there's like all these floating islands, if you go down into the abyss, there's stuff down there.
Said Renato to himself.
They sent an expedition down there, and so there's stuff down there, and they've found it, and they're just curious. I want to know more about that. Like, I would love for them to do more. I want to know what's down there. I want to know what's at the bottom of the abyss, and see it for myself. I really want to explore this place. Like, this is... Like, don't get me wrong, like, I love this setting, I love the system that they've set up here, and everything that's going on, but just the idea of getting to explore down there and find out what's going on and everything, that's just so awesome.
You almost never saw wild gogglers together like this. The toads had to train them not to peck each other to death. So these had to be Imperial gogglers. That meant ravens were up ahead. Renato felt... wrong, all over. He could feel an almost palpable sickness in the air. And if the land could have tumors, they would look like these monstrous crystals. The forest was quieter than it had been. There were insects, a few birds. He didn't catch the ravens. Renato smelled sick. The thing about puzzles was, once you solved one, you knew how to solve it again. Puzzles had no, what was the word? Replayability? Renato wondered if you could design a puzzle that would be different every time you played with it. Wouldn't that be fun? Having a goblin for a pet.
New York, everybody. Nice play there by the.
As he held the radiant icosahedron, Renato felt queasy, like dozens of tiny worms were nibbling his insides. It wasn't healthy to be so close to the eye of a god. How could he use it? He could take it to the observatory. The scientists there could tell him how to harness its ancient power. But honestly, Renato ached to get away from it. He brought the core back with him to the Farfarer. But honestly, Renato ached to be rid of it. Tell you what, said Lupino. I'll take it to the observatory. You attack the Imperial Outpost. Outpost was a vital communications node. Taking it could shatter the Empire's ability to coordinate. And it would be full of secret plans and maps and maybe even rebel prisoners.
It was a good target
for a hero like Renato.
Yes.
But... what if Lupino lost the core to the Empire? That could be a good thing, couldn't it? Was Renato ready to take that risk? Maybe it was better if he brought the core to the scientists himself.
Let's go!
Trust me, Renato, you won't regret this. I'll treat the core like it was my own baby daughter.
Well,
as the
Farfarer died
towards the Nexus, Lupino was jumping up and down with excitement. Stop rabbiting around, Renato said. Lupino just stared at him. The moment the ship landed, Lupino leapt off the ship.
I mean, like, I don't think they could do a sandbox RPG by any means, but, like, just... Not even necessarily, like, an open-world RPG or anything like that. Just some sort of narrative game, even if it's on rails, that kind of opens this world would be nice. I mean,
as Lupino vanished into the wilds of the Nexus, Renato vaguely remembered
Lupino had a baby daughter, didn't he? And he told her mother he was going out to get some Easter eggs, and he'd never come back. But Renato was relieved not to carry the core anymore. He was already feeling better. And who knows, maybe this time Lupino would get it right. And if Renato could take the outpost, he'd have access to all the Empire's communications in the sector, right?
You know, I was going to say, maybe they could do another one of these, and I'm trying to think, like, honestly, I think I would play another one of these. I really do. You know, I've been enjoying the story. I haven't... run across anything that I don't like, or find unenjoyable.
This was definitely better than pulling yourself up in a bucket.
I mean, like, yeah, even right now, like, after having I'm essentially replaying the same level again. Like, I find that this could be... Yeah, like, even if they did another one of these, I think I would be quite happy with it. Yeah, but like I said, I just, mostly just to experience more of the world.
Renato caught his breath. His joints still hurt, but he couldn't feel the poison in his system anymore. He'd let the armature slip out of his hands to save his friend Lupino. Of course he had to let Lupino take the core. The rebellion needed every man doing his duty. And the rabbit would be no good taking on an Imperial outpost, right? Took the outpost with a song in his heart. Soon he was stuffing his sack with key messages from and to the fleet. Then the Farspeaker Toad chortled a new message. The observatory had been sacked by ravens. Lupino and all the scientists had been taken to the mountains. Why? Why had he trusted Lupino again? And now the Empire had the core. Renato hailed the rebel base to warn them. But their Farspeaker didn't crowd back. Was the base under attack too? Who knew what was going on at the base? But he knew what the ravens would do to Lupino if Renato didn't rescue him fast.
Well, actually he wasn't exactly sure. It kind of depended on whether Lupino was a traitor or not. Renato just couldn't bring himself to believe that.
What are all friends for, if not to need rescuing every few days?
Yo-ho! Just go forth and save the
soul. Renato felt a twinge of doubt. Should he have gone to the base? No. Logically, wherever they'd taken Lupino was probably where they took the core, right? Oh, why couldn't Lupino have just, for once, not got himself captured? Was that too much to ask? He shouldn't be too hard on the rabbit. Oh, he meant well, and he was insanely brave. He had to admire that.
Renato didn't have vertigo. going now? We're going up. We're doing stuff. We're getting things.
Latino, anyway. There was no sign of him or the ravens who'd captured him. Just rocks and snow and the usual scouts. No sign of the core either. Was this a wild rabbit chase? Oh, trust Latino to screw up even getting captured. But what was this rebellion for, anyway? Well, Latino was a useless goof. But he was a friend. If friends didn't matter anymore, what was the point of winning this war? Bernardo's paws were getting numb. Calaveras really didn't want company, did he?
Apparently not. See, I thought this was going to be a prison camp, but I've already been here. But then again, you know, at this point, I pretty much assumed I was going to be doing nothing but repeating levels. You know, like, I really hope this game does well, because I'm enjoying it so much that I would love to see another one.
Renato thought of the choices he had made so far. Rescuing a friend and then sending him to be captured. Recovering a super weapon and letting it fall into enemy hands. Risking an assault on an enemy base for military secrets and then failing to deliver them to the rebellion. Well, at the end of the mountain path, Renato came to a clearing.
Filled with iPads.
Raven feathers and... oh, Lupino's lucky deck of cards. Well, that wasn't good.
Not iPads.
Renato hoped Lupino had not tried to cheat his captors at cards. Ravens were much better than weasels at counting, and they had a very poor sense of humor. Then, he saw what he had hoped never to see. Fresh scraps of rabbit fur. Ragged and bloody, ravens would eat anything.
By Grabthar's hammer!
Renato screamed at the sky.
I will avenge you!
The rebels had assembled their fleet. Ahead, the clouds were dark with Imperial ships. If he could reach the Emperor before the rest of the rebels did, maybe he could settle this without too much bloodshed. He set sail, and the Farfarer shot forward.
Galaxy Quest. Sorry, I did not expect the Galaxy Quest reference at all. Clearly.
Poor Lupino had never been a great warrior. The mad rabbit was good for a lark and a laugh. And a pint. The thought of ravens eating him made Renato furious. The way they were eating up the land. The way the Emperor was eating up the people with his new, bloodthirsty ways. He would make them all pay. There it was again. The back door to the portal that went to the center of the fleet.
thought I'd tag it that time. I was wrong. They'll be behind again in a second. Here comes another one!
He had given up every objective to save his friend. He had given up the armature, the core, the gem, and even Zenobia. He loved Lupino, he realized. Now the rabbit was gone. A hero looks out for his friends, even when they're gone. He would send Lupino an honor guard of ravens to serve him in the halls of the Valiant. He would avenge him. The platform used a hybrid propulsion system fueled by anti-gravity and... blinking.
Anti-gravity and wishful thinking. That is the best kind of... That's the best kind of science right there. Now we're going to the Toad King's Flare this time.
Finally, he reached the Emperor's ship. And there was Lupino, surrounded by ravens. He was alive. They'd eaten some other rabbit.
I'll save you!
He shouted with joy and flung himself at the ravens. Aw, you shouldn't have, said Lupino when the last raven was down. Renato threw his arms around his best friend. I had to come. I love you, man. You really, really shouldn't have, said Lupino. And Renato felt a rather sharp pain in his back. As he collapsed, Lupino took the dagger out of Renato's back and wiped it off on Renato's sleeve.
Oh. Why? You always have to be the hero. Brave Renato, epic Renato, super sexy Renato, and I'm sick of it.
As Renato died, all he could think was, damn it. Fooled again.
A hero who places friendship above all else. Alright, well, I think that's going to be it for today. I want to thank you guys for joining me and everybody who tuned in for the stream tonight. I will be back again tomorrow to stream... actually, Murloc Book Club. We're going to be at least playing some Heroes of the Storm with the guys, so that'll be tomorrow. I'd love to hear, if you're not here with us tonight, if you're watching this on YouTube at a later date, please leave some comments down below what you think of the story. If you think I should keep going until I find more endings. Technically, I've found 9 of them at this point, so curious what people think about me finding some more of them. I am enjoying the hell out of this, so... curious what people think. While you're down there commenting, please like and subscribe. I would appreciate that as well. You guys have a great day, and I'll see you all next time.